Welcome to Postscript. Here we hope to answer your questions and help you dig deeper into the messages and sermons at Faithbridge by talking with the teacher of the day.
Good afternoon and welcome to Postscript. My name is Tyler Riley, high school pastor, here with Ken Werlein, who just gave a very impactful message in the series Path to Purpose. And so, Ken, first off, thanks for being here with us today and sitting down with us. And I figure we could just jump right into some of these questions.
Let's do it.
Awesome. So the first is this. How are we to know if there is a decision we're making that's not part of God's plan? Like, what if God wants us to take something in our own hands and make a decision? How do we know when God is telling us to follow what he has set up?
Right. So we don't end up like an Abram in this story and Sarah. So, well, let's keep in mind, we've got some advantages to Abram and Sarai. Remember, we now live on 4,000 years later, the back end of all of biblical history. And it's all recorded for us in God's Word. And so, you remember, the Bible hadn't been written. I mean, we're just up to chapter 16 of the, like, the very beginning. And so, they didn't have God's Word to lean upon. That's number one. I would say, let's go to God's Word and say, okay, is there anything about what we're trying to decide that God's Word would give clarity on? If we're violating the premises or principles of God's Word, then we know that's off. That has to be a no. If we're not, it doesn't necessarily mean it'll be a yes, but let's go further. That would lead to, I think, the second thing that we have, and that is the leading of His Holy Spirit. We enjoy the benefit of God's Holy Spirit living inside of us if we're believers. And the Holy Spirit does show up some in the Old Testament, but He sort of just drops in for these cameo experiences, appearances, unlike after Acts chapter 2 when He comes for all of us. And so this is where we have to learn how to discern with God's Word the leadings of the Spirit. Am I feeling that peace that surpasses all understanding that guards our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus? Or am I feeling like this is a force right now? Which leads to a third thing. Check this with Christian community. Not check it with somebody who doesn't know God and who's probably going to say what you might want them to say, especially if you kind of sense the Holy Spirit saying, don't do that. Don't go to that person. Go to somebody who really knows God and knows God's Word and say, hey, let me run this by you. Just checking for wisdom here. Do you think this is wise if I move forward or not? And so these are three things that we have, the Bible, the Spirit, and the church. Okay. That Abram and Sarai, that they were just like the start of it all. And so they didn't have these advantages that we would have. I would point people real quickly to all of those.
Awesome. That's good. And then the next question is this. If God really wanted to have Abram and Sarai wait for Isaac, and they did, do you think the Muslim nation would exist?
That's a great question, which I haven't really thought about. And I guess I'll just have to go with a solid, I don't know. No. And it probably doesn't do a whole lot of good to sit around and think about it because, they did do what they did and they did have Ishmael and he did have descendants and one of those 2,600 years later would be Muhammad and there would come Islam. But it's an interesting question. I guess we'll find out from heaven's vantage point someday.
Absolutely. And then the last question is this. Is there such a thing as a providential will of God prevailing in our sin?
Yeah. And I'm going to interpret providential will of God as perfect will of God. Can the perfect will of God prevail when what? Read the second
one. Prevailing in our sin.
Yeah. After sin, can His perfect will prevail? I would say no, but I would chase it with a quick, but His permissive will can prevail through His grace. Now, what do we mean? Suppose this line is the perfect will of God. Or we call it plan A, God's plan A. Suppose we're going along, but through our sin, we drop down to plan B or plan C. Well, I guess we could say, I'm out of the perfect will of God. But does that mean that I'm hopeless? No, because through Jesus, there is grace and there's hope and there's a pathway back from whatever path we've gotten ourselves onto. So some people have called this the difference between the perfect will of God and the permissive will of God. Both are all of God, and both are full of grace. The benefit to plan A, to the extent that we can stay on that path, is that I believe generally there's fewer consequences. Path B and C and D and E and F, we can pick up some consequences that come dragging along behind us, which doesn't mean that His grace is not still available for us. No, it's plenty available, fully available, but the consequences do still come. And so the to the extent that we can preclude picking up those, all the better.
Well, great. That is all the questions that we have for this week. So thanks for sitting down with us. And thank you for being here. We'll see you next week.
Thanks for joining us for Postscript. Help us keep the podcast interactive by submitting your questions during the morning services. Learn more at faithbridge.org/postscript.